Yogis, welcome back to my YouTube channel Vidya Malavde. Today I'm going to be doing a pranayama practice with you guys. This is one of my favorite pranayams. It's called Anulom Vilom or the alternate nostril breathing or a Nadi Shodhan pranayam. Now, nadis are the energy channels of the meridians in the body, and Shodhan means the cleansing or purification of these channels. We have about 72,000 of these nadis in our body, and there are three really main nadis. The center one, which runs along the spine from your root chakra to your crown chakra, is called the Sushumna Nadi. The left one, which is the feminine one, is called the Ida Nadi. And the right one, which is the masculine one, which is the sun side of our body, which is called the Pingala. I will talk more about these if you guys are interested in a separate YouTube video. That's the part 3 of my Anulom Vilom series. But on this one, we're just going to talk about how to do the pranayam, the basic Anulom Vilom pranayam. So, this is the mudra that you will take. It's called Vishnu Mudra. Your thumb always blocks the right nostril. The last two fingers always block the left nostril. Now, the middle two fingers can either be here, or if you have pain in your joints, you can always put these two fingers in the middle of your brow. So this is the Vishnu Mudra that we will take. What we will do, I will explain and demonstrate the first cycle, and then we can do it together from the next one. So your spine is comfortably erect. You are sitting either on a chair or a backrest, whatever is comfortable for you. Spine being comfortably erect, a lot of people have a habit of doing this. When just be mindful, because when you're doing the pranayam, you suddenly become like this. So then this is not correct. Keep the chin up and back so that your neck is elongated as well. Also, very importantly, to understand that I've seen a lot of people do it like this. No forceful inhalation on exhalation. Forceful exhalations happen only in Basrika and in Kapalbhati. Here the exhalations are so light that if there is a leaf kept under your nose, it should not even move. That's how subtle this pranayam is. Okay, so that's another important thing. Also, when you have when you've just eaten the food, you will not do this pranayam. Give it at least a 3-hour gap. If you've eaten a very heavy meal, then obviously a little more gap. Secondly, people with blood pressure and asthma will not hold the breath at any time. Am I holding the breath? I will do in part 2, but just as a contraindication, you will just do the basic pranayam that I'm doing in this particular YouTube video. And also for heart patients, no holding the breath, no forcing the breath. So keep it subtle. And when you do the pranayam, actually visualize toxins being released out when you exhale. Every exhale, feel like there's fear, there's toxins, there's uncertainty, whatever is left, there's pain in your body, release it. Because visualization is the most important part of anything. If you believe and you visualize, you can manifest. So let's try and do that, because this pranayama is incredibly cleansing for your respiratory system, for your blood, for your mind, for your body. It's cleansing. It clears out all your toxins, it clears your mind, gives you focus, and it's actually said that if you do this for 45 minutes to an hour every day, which I think a lot of people are complaining are getting bored in the lockdown, it can help you rid your all the plaque in your heart. So it'll help you with, of course, the lungs. The effective functioning of the lung increases, gets better. Your heart and the blockages in your heart can get cleared by this pranayam. Also, like I said, it concentration, focus, which is missing these days, it rids you of your stress. It can give you better sleep, great hair and great skin, because there's oxygenation happening in the blood and the body and the mind. So let's get started. There is a lot more to this, which I will explain in the forthcoming videos about this pranayam. There are 3 videos I'm making. This is the part 1. So let's go ahead and take the Vishnu Mudra. I will exhale all my air out from my nostrils before I start. You just watch this one and then follow me in the next cycle. I will block my right nostril with my thumb. Inhale from the left. 1, 2. Block the left nostril with the last two fingers. Exhale from the right. 1, 2. Now I'll inhale back again from the right. 1, 2. And then block the right nostril with my thumb and exhale from the left. 1, 2. This finishes one cycle. So let's all begin. Sit comfortably, spine comfortably erect. Take the Vishnu Mudra. Inhale first. Exhale all the air out. Block the right nostril now and inhale from the left. 1, 2. Block the left nostril now. Inhale, exhale from the right. 1, 2. Inhale from the right now. 1, 2. Block the right. Exhale from the left. 1, 2. Inhale from the left. 1, 2. Exhale from the right. 1, 2. Inhale from the right. 1, 2. Exhale from the left. 1, 2. Inhale from the left. 1, 2. Exhale right. 1, 2. Inhale right. 1, 2. Exhale left. 1, 2. Inhale left. 1, 2. Exhale right. 1, 2. Inhale right. 1, 2. Exhale left. 1, 2. And release. Now if you can, I'm only taking 1, 2, you can take 3, 5, 10, it just depends on your capacity. As you get better at it, you can increase, but I think if you're just starting, just keep it very less. Even if you just take one inhale and one exhale out, no problem at all. Start slow, but get better at it. See, because everything that can be incredibly good for your system, if done wrong, can also harm your system. So you want to do it properly. So this is my session today with the beginner of the pranayam anulom vilom series. I'll also do the holding of the breath in the second series of the anulom vilom pranayam, and in the third one I will talk about the esoteric angle, like I was talking about the nadis and the cleansing of the nadis and how how beautiful it is. This pranayam is incredible for balancing your hormones as well, the balancing the left and the side of left and the right side of the body, the left and the right hemispheres of your brain, which correspond to your logical and your emotional side of the personality. So there is so much to talk about this, and I would love to give you all the details. For now, just go ahead and do this basic pranayam anulom vilom, and I will come back a little later in the second episode of this pranayam series and show you the rest. Thank you very much for joining me. Please continue with the practice, and I'm going to close this class with one chant of Om. Thank you so much for allowing me to lead you today. Take a deep inhale if you want to join me. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Lokah samastah sukhino bhavantu.